Namaste children, how are you all? I hope you are safe at home. Now, yesterday in the previous session we completed our 12.1 exercise. Now let us move to the next session, that is applications of Heron's formula in finding areas of quadrilaterals. So here we can use Heron's formula not only finding of area of a triangle. We can use this formula to find the area of quadrilateral also. Clear? How to find the area of quadrilateral when sides are given and any one of the diagonal is given. Clear? Let us discuss 2 to 3 examples. Then you can get clarity about how to find the area of the quadrilateral by using Heron formula. Now let us discuss a simple example. Now find the area of the quadrilateral. Find the area of the quadrilateral whose sides are given and one of the diagonal is given, right? So now let us discuss a simple example. Now see this here, example 1, okay, find the area of a quadrilateral whose sides are 3 centimeters, 4 centimeters, 6 centimeters and 7 centimeters. Let us take different sides, okay, and also one of its diagonal. So diagonal is, let us take that 5 centimeters. Clear? So see this, observe here they given a quadrilateral and whose sides are 3, 4, 6, 7 and as well as one of its diagonal is 5 centimeter. How to find the area of a quadrilateral? So generally, we know the formula if it is a rectangle, square, or parallelogram, or rhombus, even trapezium also. These are quadrilaterals. We can find out area by using their formula. To find the area of rectangle, we will use L into B. To find the area of square, side into side. A parallelogram is base into height. And coming to rhombus, half into product of its diagonals. Coming to trapezium, half into height into, that is half into h into some of the parallel sides. These are the formulas they given for to find area of quadrilateral. But here coming to in this solution, in this problem, now see this here, there is a quadrilateral. Yes, see this here, this is not a particular shape. It is a quadrilateral. Let us take that A, B, C, D. Clear? AB is 3 centimeters, this is 4 centimeters, this is 6 centimeters and this is 7 centimeters and one of its diagonal, I am going to take this AC as 5 centimeters. Now see this here we have separated quadrilateral into two triangles. In this, one is a triangle ABC and another one is ADC. Clear? There are two triangles are there. By using Heron formula, we will find out the area of this triangle and area of this triangle. Okay? Finally, you should add these two, you will get area of quadrilateral. So, given that, the sides of a quadrilateral ABCD are here, AB is equal to 3 centimeters, AB is equal to 3 centimeters, BC is equal to 4 centimeters, okay, CD is equal to 6 centimeters and AD is equal to 7 centimeters. Here you should write, comma, and diagonal AC is equal to 5 centimeters.
Clear? Now, let us consider
the triangle ABC. I am going to consider first of all this triangle. First of all, this is the first triangle, this is second triangle.
Clear? Let us consider triangle ABC.
In this triangle ABC, we know all the three sides. They did not given any height. Clear? 3, 4, 5 centimeters. Right, my dears? So now, by using those three sides, we will find out, first of all, semi-perimeter. Clear? So now, see this here. To find the semi-perimeter, you need to find out the sum of all the sides. That means, we need to find out, first of all, S. Now, which implies, here S is equal to A plus B plus C by 2. Right? A, B, C you can consider as. Now, S is equal to, what is the value? 3 plus 4 plus 5 by 2. So now, S is equal to, 3 plus 4 is, how much it is? 7. 7 plus 5 is how much? That is a 12. So 12 by 2, but 2 1s are 2 6s are, so therefore S equal to 6 centimeters. Here, this S for only first triangle, not for second triangle. We are finding the area of the first triangle. That's why we can consider as first triangle is ABC. Now, we got S value. So now area of triangle ABC, that is first triangle, which is equal to, we know that under root of, what is the formula here? S into S minus A into S minus B into S minus C. Clear? Now, which is implies by applying the formula, apply the values, means substitute the values S, A, B, C in this formula, you will get the answer. Now, which is implies square root of, what is S here? S equal to 6. Now, 6 minus 3 into 6 minus 4 into 6 minus 5. Now, which is implies under root of, now 6 into 6 minus 3 is 3, 6 minus 4 is 2, and 6 minus 5 is 1. Is this clear, my dears? Now, so here, so which is equal to, you have to simplify, you will get the solution. Clear? Now, which is implies under root of 6 into 3 2s are 6, 6 1s are 6. So, under root of 6 into 6, which is equal to square root of 6 square will cancel. Answer will be 6 square centimeters. Clear? So, otherwise you can write here. Which is implies, so area of first triangle, which is implies 6 square centimeters. This is equation number 1. Clear? So this is area of the first triangle ABC. Now, we can find out area of the second triangle. To find area of second triangle, we need to find out first of all, S. Okay? Now, therefore, here, to find the area of the second triangle, let us consider a triangle ACD. In ACD, S is equal to A plus B plus C by 2, same formula. Then S is equal to, what is A value? A equal to, you can take it as 5 plus 6 plus 7 by 2. Then S is equal to, what is 5 plus 6? 5 plus 6 is equal to 11. 11 plus 7 is, that is 18. 18 by 2, 2 9, 2 1s are, 2 9s are. Therefore, S is equal to here, 9 centimeters. So now we got S as 9 centimeters. Now, find out area of triangle ACD, that is second part, which is equal to, same formula we are going to apply, that is under root of S into S minus A into S minus B into S minus C. Clear? Then substitute S, A, B, C values in this formula. You will get the answer. Now which is implies? Under root of, what is S value here? S is equal to 9 cm. 9 into 9 minus 5 to 9 minus 6 into 9 minus 7. Right? Which is implies under root of 9 into 9 minus 5 is 4, 9 minus 6 is 3, 9 minus 7 is, that is 2. Right, my dears? So now, 9 and 4 are both perfect square numbers. So square root of 9 is 3, square root of 4 is 2. And 3, 2 are prime numbers. You can keep like that only, which is implies under root of, So square root of 9 is 3, I am writing outside. 3 into 2 into under root of 6 square centimeters. So therefore, that is area of the, which is equal to 6 root 6 square centimeters. This is equation number 2. That is equation number 2. Now, what we are going to do? We need to find out area of the quadrilateral ABCD. So this total quadrilateral we are divided into two parts. One is this first triangle and second triangle. And we find out, we got the answer area of the first triangle and the second triangle. So by adding these two triangles area, you will get total area of the quadrilateral. Clear? So now, I got the first value is 6 square centimeter and second is 6 root 6, 6 into root 6 square centimeter. Now, by adding those two, by adding these two values, you will get the answer. Clear? So now, I am going for doing here. So now area of quadrilateral ABCD is equal to area of triangle ABC plus area of triangle ABC plus triangle ACD. That is, by adding equation number 1 and 2, that is, equation number 1 plus 2, you will get the answer, which is implies, this is 6 plus 6 root 6, now, square centimeters. If you want to take 6 as a common, you will get the solution. 6 into 1 plus root 6, square centimeters. So, therefore, area of quadrilateral quad ABCD is equal to, that is 6 into 1 plus root 6 square centimeters. So this is your therefore statement. Is this clear, my dears? How to find the area of quadrilateral by using Iron's formula? We need to separate the quadrilateral, or we need to divide the quadrilateral into two triangles. Then find the area of each triangle. Finally, should add both the triangle areas. You'll get the solution. You get the total area of the quadrilateral. Clear? You please copy this. We'll go to the next example. Now, children, let us move to the exercise 12.2, question number 1. A path in the shape of a quadrilateral ABCD has angle C equal to 90 degrees. AB equal to 9 cm, BC is equal to 12 cm, CD equal to 5 cm and AD equal to 8 cm. How much area does it occupy? Okay, we need to find out area of the park which is in the shape of a quadrilateral ABCD. Out of 4 angles, they given one angle as 90 degrees. Now, you need to draw a diagram for the given measurements. Now, see this here. I am going to draw a park will be like this. Right, it will be BC will be 12, no? Right. Clear? Like this the park will be, right? This is, let us take a simple, like this you can take. So now, this is A, B, C, D. Clear? At angle C is 90 degrees. Now see this here, AB will be 9 cm and the BC will be 12 cm and the CD is 5 cm, okay, and AD is 8 cm. So now,
to find the area of this quadrilateral, we need to draw a diagonal. Now see this here, I'm going to draw a diagonal. I'm joining BD. Clear? Now observe here they did not given BD. Clear? But we need to find out BD value. Now observe this quadrilateral in this this part. This BCD is a triangle. Which type of triangle? Out of this triangle, out of three angles, one angle will be 90 degrees. Then this is a right angle triangle. This is right angle triangle. So by using Pythagoras theorem, we will find out the length of the BD. Clear? What is the Pythagoras theorem? In a right angle triangle, the square of the hypotenuse is equal to square of the sum of the two sides. Clear? That is BD square is equal to BC square plus CD square. Clear, my dears? That is the Pythagoras theorem. Now, this is a triangle. This is triangle 1. This is triangle 2. So, to find both the triangles areas, then add both, you will get the area of the park. Now, see this here. Given that a park is a park in the shape of a quadrilateral ABCD, right? In this angle C is equal to 90 degrees, right? And AB is equal to, that is 9 centimeters, BC is equal to 12 centimeters, CD is equal to 5 centimeters, and as well as AD is equal to, what is that? 8 centimeters. And now see this here. Now let us consider the triangle BCD is a right angled triangle. Clear? By using Pythagoras theorem, right angle triangle. So now by using Pythagoras theorem, Pythagoras theorem. Clear? So now, see this here. By using Pythagoras theorem, what is Pythagoras theorem says that in this triangle BCD, okay? Pythagoras theorem, which is implies BD square is equal to BC square plus CD square. Already in earlier classes we discussed already what is the Pythagoras theorem. So in this formula, we need to find out by using this, we can find out the value of the BD. Now see this here, substitute the value BC and as well as CD in that formula, you will get BD value. Clear, my dears? So what is the Pythagoras theorem says that hypotenuse square equal to side square plus side square. Generally, okay, in a shortcut way, we can say that in a right angle triangle, hypotenuse square equal to side square plus side square. That is the Pythagoras theorem. Now, BD square equal, this is which is implies BD square equal to, what is the BC value? BC equal to 1 centimeter, that is 12 square plus 5 square. Okay, which is implies BD square is equal to, what is 12 square? 144 plus 5 square is 25, which is implies BD square is equal to 144 plus 25 is 169. Then BD is equal to under root of 169 square, we transpose to right hand side, it will become square root. Clear? So now what is the BD value here? So if BD equal to root of 169, what is the square root of 169? What will be the square root of 169? See this here, which is implies BD is equal to square root of 169 is 13. Clear? Already we discussed in the earlier class, 8th class, square root of 169 or 13 square is 169. Clear? So now we got BD as 13 centimeter. So we got this side 13 centimeters. Now we can find out area of the triangle BDC and the last triangle BAD. Clear? Now, area of triangle BCD. Here, to find out area of triangle BCD, it may be you can use amplitude to base into height, because we know the base, we know the height. In a right angle triangle, the perpendicular sides are base into height. Or by using your own formula also you can find out. Okay, whichever it is easy, you can find out. Now, use your own formula only, because we are using your own formula. Right? Now, S is equal to, right? What is that? A plus B plus C by 2. Now, S is equal to 12 plus 5 plus 13 by 2. Then S is equal to 12 plus 5 is 17. 17 plus 13 is 30. 30 by 2, which is nothing but 15 centimeters. So, we got S value. Now, we need to find out the area of the triangle BCD. Clear? Now, to find area of triangle BCD, what is the formula we are going to use? Here one formula, that is square root of S into S minus A into S minus B. Is this clear? Now, see this here. We are going to find out area of triangle. Now, which implies area of triangle BCD is equal to under root of S into S minus A into S minus B into S minus C. Now, which is implies under root of, what is S value? 15. 15 minus 12 into 15 minus 5 into 15 minus 13. Now, which is implies under root of 15 into, I am going to write it here only. Which is implies under root of 15 into 15 minus 12 is 3, 15 minus 5 is 10, and 15 minus 13 is 2. Okay, now which is implies under root of 15 is 5 into 3 into 3, 10 is again 5 into 2 into 2. So here there are 2 5s are there, 2 3s are there, 2 2s are there, which is implies under root of 5 square into 3 square into 2 square, which is implies under root of 5 into 3 into 2 whole square. The square root will get it cancelled. The leftover part is 5 3s are 15, 15 2s are 30 square centimeters. So here area of triangle BCD is equal to 30 square centimeters. This is equation number 1. Now, in the same way, we are going to find out area of triangle BAD also. Clear? Now, see this here. So, to find out area of the triangle BAD, again we need to find out S value. Okay? By use your own formula. If you want to use your own formula, you can find out S compulsory. Now, area of triangle BAD, okay, which is implies under root of same formula S into S minus A into S minus B into S minus C. So now here S is equal to, that is A plus B plus C by 2. Then S is equal to, what is A value? Let us take 8, 9, 13. You can take any 13 plus 8 plus 9 divided by 2. Then S is equal to, what is 13 plus 17? 9 plus 8 is 9 plus 8 is 17. 17 plus 13 is 30. 30 by 2. Again, here also we got 15 centimeters. Here also we got 15. Here also 15, but size are different. Now, substitute in this formula, you will get, which is implies square root of area. What is that? 15 into 15 minus 13 into 15 minus 8 into 15 minus 9. 15 minus 9, which is implies under root of 15 into 15 minus 13 is 2, 15 minus 8 is 7, 15 minus 9 is how much? That is 6. Clear? So now which is implies, see this here, which is equal to under root of, I am going to write it here, which is implies under root of
15 is 5 into 3. 2 is as it is 2 only. 7 is a prime number. Again 6 can be as 3 into 2. Now see this, how many 3's are there? There are 2 3's are there. There are 2 2's are there. Those 2 will come outside. 5 into 7 is 35. Which is implies 3 into 2 into root of 35. So which is implies 6 root 35 square centimeter. This is equation number 2. Clear? So now we got equation number 1 as area of triangle BCD, and equation number 2 is area of triangle BAD. Clear? That we are going to add. Then you will get area of the total park. Okay? Which is implies. Now see this here. Now area of park ABCD, which is equal to equation number 1 plus equation number, or you can take 1 plus 2 directly. So now which is equal to, what is the area of this one? 30 plus 6 root 35. So you just keep it like that only. Okay? Otherwise you can take 6 as the common, you get 5 here, root 35 here. Right? So now, so therefore area of park ABCD, which is equal to 30 plus 6 into root 35 square centimeters. So this is a value to find out area of the park. This is a process to find out area of quadrilateral by using Heron formula. Is this clear, my dears? You please draw a diagonal in any quadrilateral. The diagonal divides the triangle quadrilateral into two parts of triangles. Then find out each part of the area of the triangle. Then add these two triangles, area of these two triangles. Then you will get the area of quadrilateral. Is this clear, my dears? Right. Right, children. I hope you understood that whatever we discussed right now, till now. Clear? So, you can find out area of triangle other than half into base into height formula. There is one more formula, that is Heron formula, that is delta is equal to under root of S into S minus A into S minus B into S minus C. So, by using this formula, you can find out area of triangle and as well as area of quadrilateral also. Clear? So now, I hope you understood that whatever we discussed this chapter. If anybody have any doubt, you can call me. I'll explain to you once again. This is clear, my dears? And today's homework is textbook page number 206, exercise 12.2, question number 2. Only one question. You please complete this chapter. Okay? And forward to my WhatsApp number. The chapter is completed. Clear? Thank you. Have a nice day.